does not depend upon the amount of matter contained in the system. Intrinsic property is the property which does not depend upon the amount of matter contained in the system, while extrinsic property is the property which depends upon the amount of matter contained in the system. एक एक उदाहरण देतो दोन्ही तुम्ही पण एक उदाहरण डेन्सिटी इज अ इंटेन्सिव प्रॉपर्टी वाय इज डेन्सिटी अ इंटेन्सिव प्रॉपर्टी एक ग्लास पाणी घेतलं तरी डेन्सिटी 1 ग्रॅम पर क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटर येणार एका विहिरीवर पाणी घेतलं तरी पण डेन्सिटी 1 ग्रॅम पर क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटरच येणार इफ आय टेक 1 liter of water, or even if I take 10 liters of water, the density will remain the same, and therefore I say density is an intrinsic property. Exactly the same way I will say mass is an extensive property, or I will say volume is an extensive property. एक लिटर पाणी एवढं भांड्यात असू दे 10 लिटर पाणी इट विल टेक मोर स्पेस इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द अमाउंट ऑफ मॅटर कंटेन्ड इन सिस्टम मोर द अमाउंट ऑफ मॅटर मोर इज दॅट प्रॉपर्टी द प्रॉपर्टी वी आर रेफरिंग टू इज द व्हॉल्यूम समझ में आया सब वन मोर पेयर इज एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम यू सो लेट अस सी वेदर समथिंग टेल बापट कैन यू फील द Intensive is volume, definitely.
Extensive is solubility.
Solubility, yes, chale. Melting point, refractive index, all are intensive properties. Heat capacity is an extensive property because heat capacity is the amount of heat required to raise temperature by 1 degree Celsius. थोडस पाणी असेल तर थोडीशी फील लागेल आणि जास्त येतं तर विल टेक मोर हीट सो basically you should know the concept. Agar I have classified the following into intensive and extensive property, to come in and answer. Uske baad, the various types of equilibriums which a system can accomplish with the surroundings, the various types of equilibrium which the system can accomplish with the surrounding are thermal, chemical and mechanical equilibrium. हे टेक्स्ट मध्ये दिलेलं नाहीये त्यामुळे मी टाकून नाही. The various types of equilibriums, या equilibria, that is the plural, which a system can establish with the surrounding are chemical equilibrium, thermal equilibrium and mechanical equilibrium. A system is said to be in chemical equilibrium when no chemical reaction takes part between the various components of the system or the system and the surroundings. I repeat, a system is said to be in chemical equilibrium when no chemical reaction takes place between the various components of the system and the system and the surrounding. A system is said to be in thermal equilibrium when there is no temperature difference between the various components of the system, nor between the system and the surrounding. A system is said to be in mechanical equilibrium when there is no unbalanced force acting between, when there is no unbalanced force acting between the various components of the system, or the system and the surrounding. Mandar repeat.
Chemical equilibrium is a equilibrium when there is no reaction between various components of the system and the system and the surrounding. Thermal equilibrium is when there is no temperature difference between the various components of the system and the system and surrounding. Then mechanical equilibrium is when there is no unbalanced force between the various components of the system and the system and surrounding.
And when the system is in thermal, chemical and mechanical equilibrium, and when the system is in chemical, thermal and mechanical equilibrium, the system is said to be in thermodynamic equilibrium. When the system is in thermal, chemical and mechanical equilibrium, the system is said to be in thermodynamic equilibrium. Whenever the system is in thermodynamic equilibrium, and whenever the system is in thermodynamic equilibrium, the total energy contents of the system depends upon three parameters, and the three parameters are referred to as
Thank you.
depends upon four parameters: pressure P, volume V, temperature T. Generally, system is an increasing number of moles towards that. If there is any change in the in any of these three parameters, then if you want to know the total energy of the system, then you need to know all these. If you take rid of this, then you should know all the three thermodynamic coordinates. It is necessary to know all the three thermodynamic coordinates if you want to know the total energy of the system. But it is sufficient to know only two out of them. Why? जर एखादी सिस्टम थर्मोडायनामिक इक्विलिब्रियम मध्ये आहे तर त्याची टोटल एनर्जी जर शोधायची असेल तर हे तिन्ही पण थर्मोडायनामिक कोऑर्डिनेट्स माहिती असणं अत्यावश्यक आहे. नेसेसरी व्यवस्थित नेसेसरी टू नो ऑल द थ्री थर्मोडायनामिक इक्विलिब्रियम्स बट इट इज सफिशिएंट टू नो ओनली टू आउट ऑफ देम. व्हाय? बिकॉज द थर्ड कैन बी फाउंड बाय यूजिंग but it is sufficient to know only two out of them because the third can be found using this is called as equation of state. And when can we say that there is a change in state? ऐसे हम कब कह सकते हैं when there is a change in the thermodynamic coordinates. Any one or more than one. Any of them. We say that the system is undergoing change in state. The problem is to have. And when a system undergoes a change in state, it is referred to as a process. The phenomena of a system undergoing change in state, the phenomena of a system undergoing change in state is referred to as a process. And there are various processes by virtue of which a system can undergo a change in state, and we are going to see the processes. Isothermal process. Isobaric or isobaric process. Isochoric process, choric equilibrium. When the system is in thermodynamic equilibrium, the energy contents of the system can be estimated by knowing the three coordinates. The three coordinates are referred to as the variables of state or thermodynamic coordinates: pressure, volume, and temperature. Of course, the number of moles are included in it. A system, for us to know the energy contents of the system, it is necessary for us to know all the thermodynamic coordinates, but it is sufficient to know all the three, but it is sufficient to know only two out of them, because the third can be estimated using the equation dV is equal to nRT, referred to as the equation of state. Whenever one or more of the thermodynamic coordinates undergo change, the system is said to undergo a change of state, and the phenomena by virtue of which it happens is referred to as the process. And at syllabus and lab level, we have four types of processes: isothermal, isobaric, isospheric, and adiabatic. A system is said to undergo an isothermal change when throughout the process there is no change in the temperature, volume badli number, temperature badli, pressure badli. A system is said to undergo isobaric process when there is no change in pressure, that is P is constant or delta P is zero. A system is said to undergo an isochoric process when its volume does not change, that is V is equal to constant or delta V is equal to zero. A system is said to undergo an adiabatic process when it does not give heat, neither it accepts heat, that's delta Q is equal to, or Q is equal to constant. Thermodynamics. define thermodynamics. And state the limitations of thermodynamics. And state the limitations of thermodynamics. Next. What do you understand by this? A. System surrounding boundary and universe. Next. What do you understand by? A. Open system. B. Closed system. C. Isolated system. Next question. Define and give examples of A. Intensive property and B. Extensive property. A. Intensive property and B. Extensive property. Next. Define the three equilibriums. Define the three equilibriums and hence define thermodynamic equilibrium. Next question. What do you understand by thermodynamic coordinates? To know the total energy contents of a system. It is necessary to know all the three thermodynamic coordinates. But it is sufficient to know only two out of. come in. Next question. What do you understand by change of state? What do you understand by change of state? Next question. Explain the following processes. Samor lila dele. And 2 minutes samor se pehle ese thil lunge karan esa kai part text madhe nahi hai. फटाफट लिहून घ्या बोर्डवरचं जे पण लिहिलं बोर्डवरती सगळं म्हणजे ना गडबड नाही होणार.